Hello everybody, I am Fuzzy Face and welcome back to this Motorsport Manager series. We're currently back with the Ferrari Challenge. We're on Season 3, Episode 7. We're back today with the Monaco Grand Prix. This is Charles Leclerc's home race. He will be looking to win this race, but Schumacher will be looking for revenge after the last race at the Hockenheimring in Germany. Leclerc took the win there, won at Schumacher's home Grand Prix, so Schumacher should be looking for revenge here. What we are doing at the moment is, or what we're not doing rather, is that I have stopped upgrading the car from this point on. Maybe we'll build a few more new parts just before the end of the season. Maybe just do an extra one part. But just because we're so overpowered, we don't really need to spend so much money now going forward. We can just sort of dial back on what we're doing at the moment. Just sort of let the other cars catch up a bit. Because we are so overpowered, maybe we should go for a little bit more challenge for next season, because next season is possibly going to be the last race in this Ferrari game. Maybe forever, maybe for a little bit, but the downloadable content is coming out tomorrow, which will be today. I think it comes out on the 22nd. So it will come out tomorrow for me. It will come out today. It will be out on the day that this video is actually released, because I do film a day in advance. But hopefully I can do a quick series just messing about with the GT downloadable content that's coming out. It looks quite interesting, so maybe we'll try to do a quick series on that before we move on to the 2017 mod. The cars under consideration for the 2017 mod at the moment are McLaren, Renault and Haas. They're the teams that we're looking at going with next season. All of those three would present interesting challenges, so if you have any ideas in the comments of who you would like me to go with for the 2017 mod when we get around to that series, please leave a comment down below. But that's what we're getting on with. So we've got the Tour Centre Staff Centre almost about built, 6 weeks away. Performance improvements, just working on the parts we've got in the car as we're not building any new parts at the moment. HQ, we've gone through. Mail, we've just come into this. We've got a new vote starting points for the top eight. It looks like it's in favour four at the moment. This rule will not benefit traditional teams, it won't benefit us, but we're always going to abstain. I do like to just see what the computer goes with. So we'll just see whether it's going to be points for the top eight next season, and it is. We're only going to have points for the top eight teams, for the top eight cars next season. So the cars that finish in 9th and 10th won't be getting points next season. And the points will be going back to the traditional rules for a 10, 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Just like they used to be before we switched to the 25 starting point. So that is going to be interesting next season. There's not going to be a lot of points on offer. And it's going to mean that things are a little bit tighter. Because currently there's a massive gap between the 25 points and finishing 10th, 1 point. Whereas it would be 10 points for here, 1 point for here. So there's not that massive gap. Won't be able to build as big a lead up as we are doing at the moment. It's always going to be a little bit closer, so maybe that will be a little bit more interesting next season if a couple of the other cars start to catch us up. But anyway, we're going to jump into the Monaco Grand Prix now. We're going to run qualifying, we're going to run practice, all that sort of jazz, and we'll come back for the grid and see how we can get on in the Monaco Grand Prix. Charles Leclerc managed to get pole position in his home Grand Prix at Monaco. Schumacher second on the grid. Second row of the grid, Daniel Ricciardo, Sebastian Vettel as usual, followed by Max Verstappen and Nico Rosberg in the Williams. Fourth row, Nico Hülkenberg in the Force India, Valtteri Bottas in eighth in the Williams. Ninth and tenth, we have Kimi Raikkonen and Lewis Hamilton in the Force India and McLaren respectively. 11th, Daniel Giancarlo, Julian Palmer in the Toro Rosso in 12th. 13th, we have Fernando Alonso in the Renault, Roman Grosjean in 14th. On the 8th row of the grid, we have Marcus Ericsson in the Renault in 15th, Pascal Wehrlein in 16th. Then in 17th, we have Louis Delatraz in the McLaren, 18th. Jack Aitken up off the back row of the grid in the Racing Engineering car. Jean-Éric Vergne this time on the back row of the grid in the Manor, along with Norman Nato in the other Racing Engineering car. So it's going to be interesting. We need a good start from both our cars this time. We don't want Schumacher to have another bad start here. Here we go off the line. Charles Leclerc away again. Straight off the line. But Schumacher again. Pretty slow. And he's under pressure from Vettel again. Maybe we can try to turn this engine up here. Just try and stay ahead of Vettel. We don't want Schumacher to lose his place. If he can't get ahead after these next couple of corners, he's going to have to dial back and wait for the Mercedes to turn down their engine. And it looks like that's what's going to happen here. We're still going to push the tyres, but we're going to flick back to medium mode. Because as we know, the Mercedes like to really push their fuel load. running the richest mode that they can. Charles Leclerc has actually gone down to second place here as well. And he's lost a place to Sebastian Vettel as well. Vettel into the lead. So we're having a little bit of nightmare, but Leclerc managing to get past us in. No, he's still stuck behind Daniel Ricciardo. Can he get a run out of the corner there, around this hairpin corner? Charles Leclerc back into second place here. We're going to turn his engine down as well. We're just going to wait here for Sebastian Vettel to chain his engine down. But Sebastian Vettel is out in front. Leclerc second. Schumacher challenging Daniel Ricciardo there. But he's now going to get overtaken by Verstappen. He gets caught out by that move there. Verstappen dives up the inside. Mick Schumacher all the way back in fifth place here. We're still waiting for them to turn their engines down. Maybe we can go back to high mode with Mick now. Just waiting for these tyres to warm up. Whereas Leclerc now is in second place. But Vettel's still pushing his engine. He's going a long time in overtake mode this time. But Leclerc is doing a good job of hanging on to it. Even in this mode, Vettel keeps switching between, so maybe we can go back to high mode now. If we go back to high mode, we should be able to easily take this Mercedes at some point. Although I'm not sure what the overtaking's like on this Monaco track. Maybe it's really hard like in real life. But there has been a few moves so far, so hopefully we can get back past. Schumacher, meanwhile, is back up into fourth. He's managed to get past Max Verstappen. The Red Bull's still running in high mode, especially Ricciardo. Schumacher about 2 seconds behind there. Leclerc, meanwhile, has managed to get past Sebastian Vettel. Leclerc is now out in the lead in his home Grand Prix. So it looks like he's possibly going to get the win here, because Schumacher, once again, due to a poor start, is struggling a bit further down the order than what we would like him to be. Just waiting for these tyres to get up to temperature as well. Maybe we can try push these tyres a little bit more, because what we're going to have to do with Schumacher, he can only do one stint on the Ultrasoft, because his tyre wear is a little bit worse than Charles Leclerc. He does have to go for the slower tyre for his last two stints. So he's going to have to do Ultrasoft and then two sets of Supersoft, whereas Leclerc can do this on three sets of Ultrasoft if we want to. The temperature is pretty low, so Supersoft is possibly going to be a little bit better at some point. Maybe we can, just because of how I've gone a little bit too far there with Mick, haven't we? But anyway, we can go into the super softs with him. Maybe we can get him into the pits and then push on these new tyres. But since the temperature is so low, maybe the harder compound tyres might run a little bit better on this track. The ultra softs, not the greatest in cold weather, because it takes quite a while to get them up to temperature. So maybe the harder tyre compound can run in the lower temperatures or at a quicker speed. As we've seen, Raikkonen is getting up there. He's managing to stay ahead of Hamilton. A lot of cars in the pits now. Schumacher has come in. Where's he going to get out of the pits? He's out in fifth. Lost a place to Vettel there. Vettel's gone for another pair of Ultrasofts. We're going to push this car. We somehow need to get Schumacher back up the order. Charles Leclerc is coming round about now, so he's going to go back onto another pair of Ultrasofts here as well. I think we've got enough gap to be comfortable here. We're gaining as well over Kimi Raikkonen, who should be holding up a couple of these cars in front. So should we try desperately to try and get back past here? We've got to try something, haven't we? As Vettel has been held up by Bottas, we should have the run on Bottas down here. Can we get the run on Vettel as well? There we go. We want the run on Raikkonen. We're just now chasing down Daniel Ricciardo, who is on a harder tyre compound than us, so we can go back down like this. And we should get on this hairpin. Can we get the run out of this? Down the straight here, down the back into second place with Mick Schumacher there. So he's recovered at lap 10. That has taken Schumacher a long time to get back into second place there. We're going to have to start thinking about recovering some of this fuel. We really need to get some temperature in this tyre of Charles Leclerc as well. We left him sort of just dawdling there in conserve mode. He's got a ton of fuel as well, so let's do a lap with him. Let's just see what sort of lap we can get out of a nearly fresh pair of Ultrasofts. We got a couple of back markers blocking him off here. He did a 109 last time out. What is he going to do this time? He's at 1.2 seconds quicker already on his last lap. Charles Leclerc, what's he going to be able to do? One point, he's almost 2 seconds quicker at the moment. So he looks like he's going to get into the 107s. A 107.2, an absolutely amazing lap from Charles Leclerc there. He's pretty much used up all his excess. We've got the temperature, we've got the tyre temperatures right in the right range now. Got Schumacher behind him. He does need to recover some fuel at the moment. But he's going to be able to, look like they're going to be to go to about the same part of the race before they come and make their pit stops, even though they're on different compound tyres. Should allow Leclerc to pull away since he can go for a quicker compound tyre just because he is not as bad at wearing his tyres down as Schumacher is. So even though Schumacher is the better driver, Leclerc does have some trait and stat positives. He can make his tyres last longer and he does have an easy on fuel trait as well, which means he can go a lot longer. He can push for a lot longer than Schumacher can, so he can run in this high mode for a hell of a lot longer than that of what Mick Schumacher can do. And that really affects his lap times. As we can see, Charles Leclerc is now 20 seconds ahead here. Absolutely amazing. We're coming around to lap a few cars, it looks like, as well. Have we already lapped a couple? No. Yeah, we've gone past a few, have we? No. Yeah, we've gone past NATO already, haven't we? And we're coming up behind Ericsson. Can't figure it out then for some reason. And Schumacher second place still. So let's go down the order a little bit since we've got a little bit of time. We've got another lap here before we have to start coming in pits. So we've got Ricciardo third, Hülkenberg doing pretty well up into fourth. Vettel has already made his second pit stop and gone onto a pair of soft tyres, so he should be able to get through to the end of the race. Max Verstappen has done the same, he's in sixth. Bottas seventh, Rosberg eighth, Hamilton in the points in ninth. The other Mercedes are junking down in tenth. Palmer 11th, Roman Grosjean in the Toro Rosso in 12th, Alonso, Wehrlein, Verne, Raikkonen, Delatraz, Aitken, Ericsson and NATO. Go a little bit longer on this tyre. And Schumacher does have to come in for another pair of super softs here. So a balanced pit stop from Schumacher. And he should be able to push his tyre till the end. There's a mistake on his pit stop there, but not too bad. He's out into fourth. But Hülkenberg and Ricciardo still have to pit here. Oh, I've let Leclerc go around twice. What am I doing? Not even concentrating. I hate being so far out in front because you don't concentrate as much. Right, so balanced. Right, we're going onto another pair of ultra softs here. He's been overtaken by... He's going really slow here. Shouldn't matter unless Schumacher can get past him. Ah, look at him going so slow. Daniel Ricciardo's coming round, but Daniel Ricciardo does have to pit again. Right, so we've got a lot of life left in this ultra soft tyre for the end of the race. And a mistake as well. Oh, and there goes Schumacher. There goes Schumacher. Oh, no. We've messed the race up for Charles Leclerc here, totally. Schumacher is going to have to turn down. He's absolutely coming back here. Can Leclerc do it? Can Leclerc get this race back? Oh, we totally messed the race up for Charles Leclerc. He's got enough time that he can possibly catch him. No, no, no. He's slowing down a little bit now. Is he going quicker? Charles Leclerc is the quicker car of the two. He does a 1:08. He's picking up about 2 seconds per lap. Is there enough for him to keep going here? Don't want these tyres to run out of Schumacher's either, whereas Leclerc's got a lot of life left in this ultra soft tyre. And he can push for a lot longer. Is he still gaining here? It's going to be close coming to the end of this race, isn't it? Can Leclerc get the win back? Can Leclerc get the win back here? He's within 3 seconds now. He's within 3 seconds. Is Leclerc going to do it? Under 3 seconds. Leclerc charging here. Four laps remaining. 2.5. Is Leclerc going to get back past Schumacher? Oh, I'm going to feel so terrible if Leclerc doesn't actually win this race. Too busy worrying about what the other cars were doing, looking through them and not concentrating on what Leclerc's doing. Here we go, 3 laps remaining. Leclerc does still have some room to push, whereas Schumacher does have to turn down at this point. Leclerc, meanwhile, is right on the back of Mick Schumacher. Is he going to be able to do it? We're going to have to turn down as well with Leclerc. right about until this gets to point two. We can still do it. Leclerc is right on the back. Is he going to get it? And there Leclerc goes through with two laps remaining. An absolutely amazing performance there from Leclerc. Schumacher's tyres are just about gone, but he's got enough gap that we don't have to worry. Schumacher couldn't hang on till the end of the race there. At least we have a little bit of drama for once in this series from messing up Leclerc a little bit. But Leclerc is so quick here. Just because he can go that little bit longer. But his ultra softs, the cliff drop off is a lot higher for these ultra softs. So they do start losing performance a lot quicker than what the super softs or the soft would do, the medium. The hard tyre can go all the way to 0%. Is that going to give Schumacher... Schumacher can actually push here a little bit. Is it going to give Schumacher enough to come back? It doesn't look like it. And here we go. We're coming to the line. Schumacher not being able to fight back here. Leclerc finishes in first place. Schumacher second place. What a close run thing that was at the end. That's because we've let Charles Leclerc go too long on the ultra softs for a couple of laps there, didn't we? As we were concentrating on the other cars. Schumacher had about a 10-second lead after the pit stop, but Leclerc managed to charge him down, get into a 4-second lead there. Absolutely amazing from Charles Leclerc to win his first Formula One race in Monaco. Not his first Formula One race, obviously, but it's his first win at Monaco in the Formula One cars. Absolutely amazing from Charles Leclerc there. So that puts him now 3 race wins above Mick Schumacher. We shouldn't have any problems with scrutineering. Daniel Ricciardo has been caught and demoted 6 places. And the other Red Bull as well. Max Verstappen demoted 8 places. So the Red Bull is obviously running something really risky there, which is going to give Williams and Mercedes a good chance at catching back up to them now. Vettel goes into 3rd place. Was he in 3rd place anyway? I don't think so, was he? Vettel's only just managed to get that, or maybe it was, but not as close. And Red Bull now, their gap has closed to 3 points. Williams are just behind them. Mercedes coming in as well, just behind them. They've got McLaren, Force India, and Toro Rosso battling it out for 6th place. Renault and Manor battling it out for 8th place. And then Racing Engineering are a lost cause, it seems, already. So there we go, another amazing race there. I would have felt so bad if we'd have totally messed that up for Charles Leclerc there, but luckily he found the speed from somewhere. If that's the difference between the ultra soft and the super soft, that always shows that you should just go, no matter what the track conditions are, whether it's warm or cold, you should always just go for the quicker tyre. Just always go for the quicker tyre, because these guys that were in very similar cars, there's like 5 point difference between the cars. One, the engines are within about a 10 point gap, I think. The gearbox is pretty near. That just shows the difference between the tyres there at the end. What a fresh pair of ultra softs could do over a partially warm pair of super softs. Just amazing to get, like, in those last, what was it, about 6 laps? He managed to be 14 seconds quicker over those 6 laps, did Charles Leclerc. Absolutely amazing. He's now got a 21 point gap. Carlos Sainz won in Montreal. Kvyat second. Sigoto in third in the Rapax. Got the 2 ART cars at the top now. Sainz actually beating Button in the standings. That would mean ART have now got themselves a nice gap here. So it looks like we're going to be seeing ART in Formula 1 next season. So yeah, another amazing race. So Leclerc wins. Car condition podium. Home race win. Home race winner. So he's got an even bigger morale boost. And a hard fought win for Leclerc in Monaco. We've got Silverstone coming up. It's going to be a bit of rain in qualifying. We might get some rain in the race. It doesn't look like that at the moment. Top speed, medium speed corners, and rear wings crucial. Should be another race we're expecting to win. Hopefully we can get Schumacher starting off the line. It is costing him this championship. It is the way he starts races, because he's getting held up something shocking by the Mercedes and Red Bulls when he falls behind them. He even fell as far as 5th place this time out, which I think the worst start he's had. He does manage to recover it towards the end of the race, but it took him a long time this time to get back into second place. It took him 10 laps. Meanwhile, as he's trying to do that, Leclerc's just building out this massive lead as he's got clear air and just out in front. But yeah, hopefully we can solve that for the next episode. But that should be up a bit later today at 5 p.m. GMT time. But until next time, thank you everybody for subscribing, liking, commenting on all these videos. But I will see you down the road in Silverstone, and goodbye.